everyone, welcome back to my new video. In today's video, we are going to solve spirally traversing a matrix. And today's problem on that is very much common question, and it asks many companies interview like Paytm, Flipkart, very popular company asks question this question. And this type of question is very much some tricky but very much easy. So before starting today's video, please like and share, and if you are new, please subscribe. In today's video, first we explain the problem statement, then we solve the implementation using some examples, and then brute force approach of this problem statement and code with complexity. Okay, so go to problem statement. In problem statement, you have given a rectangular matrix and your task is to return an array while traversing the matrix in a spiral form. Okay, spiral form means like this way. This is a spiral form. Okay, this is a spiral form. Now go to first example. In first example, given square rectangular matrix is this. This is a matrix given. First, our task is traversing this rectangular matrix. We start from this one, then we go to rightmost side 4, then we traverse bottom element is rightmost 8. Then again I go to bottom, rightmost is 12. Then again we go to rightmost 16. Okay. Now any other element is not there. It is the last 16. Then we go to leftmost value 15, 14, 13. Then we go to up, leftmost value 9. Then we again go to up, leftmost value 5. Then we traverse right side value 6, 7. And then again we go to down, 11 and 10, and you can see it also create a spiral form. It is create a spiral form, you can see. Okay, so in output it will show first 1 2 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4, then 8, then 8, then 12, then 16, then 15, 14, 13. Okay, 15, 14, 13, then 9, we go to up, 9, 5, 6, 7, 7. Then I go to down, 11 and 10. So in output, this value will show. This value will show. Okay, now go to next example. In next example, given this matrix, and first we traverse from this one, then we go to traversing all of this element and go to down 8, then again we go to down this, then we go to left value the 11 10 9, then go to up 5 6 7. Okay, we reached, and it also we traverse, and every element will traverse at once. Okay, note that. So in output it will show 1 2 3 4 8 1 2 3 4 8 12 11 10 9 5 6 7. That's it. This will be showing in output. Now, what is the brute force approach of this? Brute force approach, first we create an empty list, and empty list result to store spiral order. Then we define four boundaries, like our direction, which direction we are traversing. We can see we are traversing left, right, bottom and top. Okay. So we initialize that boundaries, top, bottom, left, right. Then we traverse the matrix using loop. So traverse from left to right along the top row, increment top. Then we traverse top to bottom along with right in column. Then we decrement right. Okay, mind it. If we traverse from left to right along the top row, then increment top. And if we traverse top to bottom along with right column, then we decrement right. Then we create if condition, if top is less than equals to bottom, top value is less than equals to bottom, then we traverse from right to left. This top value, this is suppose this is a top value and this is bottom value. Okay, this top value is less than equals to bottom value, then traverse right to left, then traverse right to left side along the bottom row. Then we decrement the bottom. Then if left is less than or equal to right, then we traverse bottom along to left column and then we increment left. And this operation will repeat until our all boundaries covers, until we traverse all of the values. This traverse loop will continue. Okay. And at the last line, we just return the list. We complete the traversing. Okay. Now, in code, first we create initialize result variable, and this result variable store the spiral order, and then we create if condition. If matrix is empty, then it will return an empty list in case matrix is empty. Okay, and then we initialize the boundaries top, bottom, left, right, and then we create a while loop to traverse the matrix or using all boundaries. So we create a while loop, and while top is less than equals to bottom and left is less than equals to right, then it will maintain this for loop for I in range, left, right, right will increment, and top will move to boundary down. Then we traverse top to bottom. For this we create this for loop for I in range, and it will then go to right boundary left. Then we create a if condition. If this if condition will check if there are still rows to traverse. If and traverse from right to left, it will. So for this we create a for loop, and then bottom boundary will up. Okay, bottom boundary will up. Then we check if there are still columns traverse. Then it will follow this for loop. Okay, to traverse bottom to top, left boundary, and then we move to left boundary right. Then at the last line, we return the list which are containing the all of our spiral order, which are containing all of our spiral order. Okay, now what is the time complexity of this? Time complexity will be O of n square. Why O of n square? Because this in this approach, we visit each element of matrix exactly at once we visit all of elements in matrix at once. You can see while we traversing, we visit only once. So in this case, for matrix is sizes n into n, and in this case operation time complexity will be n square. That's it. And space complexity will be same as it is O of n square. Because result list store all n square elements of matrix, and additional variable used like bottom, top, left, right boundaries required for constant space. So it will be O of n square space complexity. Okay. Now go to code. And now compile and run. Okay. Now submit. We solved today's problem. Hope so. Today's video is helpful to you. See you next video. Till then, tada bye.